Are you ready to rodeo? That's right, we are getting ready to create some fun rodeo art. We are actually going to be creating a rodeo clown. That's right, we are going to be drawing our own portrait of a fun, full of personality rodeo clown. But these guys are more than just entertainment. They are actually out there to protect the cowboys. So they are the unsung heroes. They are athletes, they are brave, and they're out there to keep those cowboys from getting hurt from the bulls or the bucking broncos. And they also, while doing it, they put on the funny clothes and the fun makeup and they give us a little show. So let's get our pencils and our paper and get started and draw our rodeo clown. The first thing you're going to do is draw a large U for your head. Use your hand as a guide to make sure that it's bigger than your hand. Then, very lightly as a guide, you can draw a line down the middle and across your face. This will help you keep your face centered. Draw a circle for the nose in the middle of your face, and then your eyes will go right where that line is across the top of your head above your nose. This helps keep them even. Draw them about the same size. You can make them winky eyes. You can make them closed, open. You decide how to draw your eyes. Give them eyelashes and draw a mouth. Give it a nice big happy smile. We have some happy rodeo clowns. You decide if you want lips or just a simple cheeky smile. And the hat is really easy. We want to draw a big cowboy hat. So start with almost like a hot dog shape on top. And then draw a large M on top of that, and you have one of those 10-gallon cowboy hats. You can add a little band to it, some patches, or a design. You decide what you want on it, maybe even a flower. Add some hair. You can make it long, short, scraggly, straight, curly. You decide how you want your hair to be. And the neck is just two little lines. And now time for the shoulders. And make sure the arm lines go all the way down to the bottom of the paper. Here's the fun part. Let's design the rodeo clown's outfit. You can add a bandana. You can add, or a handkerchief. Or you can add, how about some suspenders? You could add buttons. You can add whatever designs you want on the shirt. You decide. It can be as fun and funky as you want. Here I'm just adding polka dots and I'm gonna add some triangles to the other side. You can choose any shapes or designs you want. Maybe add some stripes. For the background, add diagonal and horizontal lines and add some triangle flags on them. So it makes him look like he's at the rodeo. Now grab your Sharpie and trace very carefully all of your pencil lines. So everything you drew, you're going to trace with Sharpie. And we can't forget the clown's makeup. Oh my. So add whatever design you want to have for your clown's makeup. I'm going to do a simple tracing around the mouth and a heart around one eye. And then I have that awesome nose that we'll color red later. When you are done outlining, get your eraser out, erase all your extra pencil lines to make your paper look nice and neat. Now we're ready to add some texture and color. So I have a red crayon, you choose whatever color you want for your hat. And I have this awesome textured mat. It kind of has like a burlap texture. I'm just going to stick it underneath my paper and I'm going to color with a crayon that has no paper on it so I can use the entire side of the crayon. And I'm going to press pretty hard, hold your paper in place, and color in the lines, color your hat nice and neatly. Now I'm going to move on to the background. I have a brown crayon to represent the dirt in the rodeo arena, and another texture plate that I put under my paper, and I'm coloring with the side of my brown crayon, coloring all of the area of my paper that I did not draw on. So around the cowboy hat, around the flags, and I'm trying not to get any of it on my rodeo clown, just on the background. When you are done with your texture rubs, make sure you remove all the texture plates and get to coloring the rest of your picture. So remember to be nice and neat, color one section, one direction, stay in the lines. Anything that you want to stay white, you just don't have to color. So I'm going to leave the area around the mouth white, like it has white makeup on. So I will not color that in because my paper's already white. When you're ready to color your skin, choose a skin color. So I chose a peach color that is closest to my skin color, and I'm coloring nice and neat where there wouldn't be any makeup on the clown's face. You might choose to have more white on your clown's face. That's up to you. And then color your hair and all the fun designs on your clown's outfit. And then you can color your flags. I chose primary colors, red, yellow, and blue for my clown's outfit. And then secondary colors, purple, orange, and green for the flags. You decide how your clown and flags are going to look. When you're all done coloring your fun clown, then you are ready to get your oil pastels out. So I love working with oil pastels. They're kind of like paint in a stick. Remember, they can be a little messy, so you might want to have something to wipe your fingers on and try not to smear it on your paper. Let it set and dry a little bit. I'm not coloring in my entire picture. I've already done that with my crayons. So as you can see, I just went around the edges of my face and I added some darker lines on my skin. I added a little bit of darker color where I think there might be shadow. You can add some more color and add some more designs to your hat and to your clothing. Go around the edge of your hat with the same color oil pastel to kind of make it pop, give it a little form. If you need to make your designs a little brighter, want to add some polka dots to something, go for it. Add some detail, have fun with it. Your hair, you need to add some lines in your hair to give it texture. And look how much brighter and vibrant my hair on my clown looks now that I added different shades and different colors of oil pastel to it. Here are some examples of my finished rodeo clown. So this is the one I just showed you, and here's a couple more that I've done in the past. I hope they give you some inspiration for yours, and I can't wait to see what your rodeo clowns look like. Bye.